Welcome to this presentation on developing a TS diagram for a vapor power system. As I work through this problem, I will be doing a assuming an ideal Rankine cycle. So what that means is when I look at the values for the turbine, I'm going to assume that the turbine is isentropic, but I'll show what happens if there is an efficiency so you can see how to draw that appropriately, as well as both the pumps are isentropic as well. And then we're assuming no losses in the pipes. So again, I'll show you how all that process works. So you can see all the state numbers here. Now, I'm not going to show this a diagram again. You can access it via, I'll provide a link for it in the description. And so you can look at it while you see me processing and create the TS diagram from it. So you can see how everything works together, okay? As we go forward, the only thing that I would have to need, that I would need information on from this diagram that I can't get from just knowing it's an ideal Rankine cycle, is this value right here, the last working fluid point where it leaves the turbine. I need to know, and actually for all of them, I would need to know if they are in the superheated area or if they're a two-phase mixture. And so for this case, if I go up, well, let me show you here. If I go, let me see if I can drag it over here. Over here, up to the table. I'd have to look at state 11 and look at this value for H. Let me see up here. And look that up in a table and see that it actually is under the vapor dome. Whereas 7, 8, 9, and 10 are all still superheated. All right, so that's the only information. Everything else I will work out based on knowing this is an ideal Rankine cycle. So I just want to let you know that, know that ahead of time. All right, so going back to our figure, all over the place here. Sorry about that. Okay, so this is what we'll start with. And yeah, so see if you can pull it up separately as you file the video. Thanks. All right, so I have my vapor dome drawn on my TS diagram here. And so I'll just start where we normally start, which is before the first turbine. And I see I got seven states 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. All coming out of my turbine. So all those are going to be a different pressure line. So let me draw those lines on there. So I'll draw one for 7. And I'll draw one for where 8's going to be on. Got one for 9. One for 10. And one for 11. So I do that so I can hopefully aim everything and line it up just right. Now remember what I said. So 7, 8, 9, 10 are all superheated, whereas 11 is in the vapor dome. So let me make sure that I'm gonna get 10 here, and I'm gonna put 11 right below it. So this is the ideal Rankine cycle. So that means everything is isentropic. So it's gonna be straight down between all the before and after we go through a different stage of the turbine. All right, so they're all gonna go nice and straight. All right, nice and isentropic. I'll keep drawing it up here. All the way up to state 7. And here's 8, and here's 9. All right, now I did say what would happen if we had some efficiency. So if there was efficiency in this case, what would happen is, let me draw that in yellow so we're clear that this is not the case. I would draw down first to 8, as I have drawn it, as an isentropic, and I would call it 8S. Then I would come back and I would draw a second one, and I would do a dashed line here, and that would be the actual case 8. So it has some increase in entropy moving to the right, So here is where it would have been isentropic, but with the efficiency, it ends up here a little bit to the right. So notice what happens here. The temperature is a little bit higher, right, at the outlet of the turbine, of that stage of the turbine. And as a result, the enthalpy is also going to be slightly more in the non-isentropic case when there is efficiency than when it's isentropic. So look at the overall delta. If this is the, if at state 7 we have the same H in both cases, but this H is lower, this H is higher, then the delta between 7 and 8S is going to be greater than the delta between the enthalpy at state 7 and the enthalpy at state 8. So the reason why that's important is if I go back and I write down here, hey, what's my work of the turbine is equal to the mass times the enthalpy at state 7 minus the enthalpy at state 8, right? So if we're dealing with the isentropic case, it's going to be a greater delta. I'm going to get more work out of my turbine in the isentropic case and less work because of the delta here for the non-isentropic case. So that's very important. We're going to the right, and because of the overall constant pressure curve here, I end up being with a higher enthalpy or and a less of a change in entropy, so less work being done there. All right, if I would continue on, and again, I'd have some efficiency here between 8 and 9. I draw my isentropic case first, and then I would do my dashes line over to 9. So I keep doing that the whole way down. This would be 10S. This would be the actual state 10 and all the way down to 11. So this, if 11 was actually under the dome, I'd have to redraw this such that I would get 11 under the dome. All right, so maybe redraw the dome like this or something like that. All right, so just heads up. But because they're all isentropic, in this case, it's the blue, it's straight down. All right, so that's where we're good here. All right, so let's go back to blue, get back into our case here. So we're 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 11 down there. We go down, we're going through the condenser. Now, in an ideal case, what happens is if we go through the condenser, we're going to come out at a sat liquid. All right, so we're going to track that over. I'm going to say, hey, we got a sat liquid at state 1. Again, this is the ideal case. If it's not ideal, they need to give you a little bit more information, or if they don't, the assumption would be that it's a sat liquid coming out of the condenser. But it could be subcooled, but again, typically they're going to give you that, well, they will give you that information. The other thing I want to label here, and I'll do it in red, is I'm going to label the different pressures here. And so you have to go back to the table to see what these pressures are, but I'm going to write them on here for you. So up here at the top, we got the 5,000 kilopascals. And this is great for record keeping, so you know where everything's at and make sure everything is going to line up well. I got 1,910. Oops. Kilopascals. And I got 620 kilopascals, 140 kilopascals, and 20 kilopascals. All right, so that'll help us to make sure we get everything in the right place as we go through our system here. All right, so let me go back to blue here. All right, so after one, we go through a pump, right? Again, ideal cycle, so we're going to go straight up. And the important thing is to make sure we go to the right pressure at two. So to figure that out, we have to actually go a little bit further. So from two, we don't really know what the pressure is, just looking at the diagram. If we go over to three, we see that three goes into the, basically it's an open feed water heater. It's a kind of a mixing chamber. So we can look at that as an open feed water heater. And it goes with 9. All right, so it's on the same pressure curve as 9. So 9, 3, 4, as well as 2, because 2 goes through a closed water heater to get to 3. So 2 and 3, 9. So I'm on the same pressure curve as 9. So let me draw 9. Here's a pressure curve for 9. So I'm going from 1 up to 2. Because 2 goes to the pressure at that 9 is at as well. Again, let me take a break here to say, if this was not isentropic, because for the ideal case it is isentropic, if it was not isentropic, that would be 2S. And then, like Beyonce was wrong, I'd go over here a little bit to the right and say, okay, that's the actual 2 point right there. All right, so that's what we would do in that scenario. All right, so I go from, I got 1 to 2. Because it's isentropic case, so 2 to 3. So I'm going to heat up to 3. How hot am I going to get at 3? All right, I don't quite have enough information there. I have a pretty good idea, but I'm going to hold off on doing 3 right now. Let's go back here to 10. All right, so if I look at 10, my plot here, so I'm going to go 10. 10, we're going to go through the closed feeder water heater, and we're going to go down to 14. So 14 is going to be a liquid, so a sat liquid at 14. So let me put 14 on there. All right. And now, actually, that does give me enough information because I know with 3, 3 can never be hotter than 14. All right, so I can go back and do 3 now and say, hey, 3 can never be higher in temperature than 14. All right, because of the energy exchange that's happening there. So that's where 3 ends up. Now 3, if we try to continue on with numbers, we go 3 to 4. So 4 is exiting from where 9 and 3 combine. So that's going to take us up to 4 being a sat liquid. All right, 4 gets pumped up to 5. 5 is going to be the same pressure as 6, because 5 to 6 is a closed feed water here. And 6 is at the same pressure as 7, so it's all going to be on that max pressure curve there. So we'll bring that one down. So 4 to 5 is isentropic case. Again, if it was, if we had some efficiency, we put our dashed line in here and we go to 5. And the original one would have been 5S, but that's not the case in the one. In this scenario, where it's all isentropic. 6 we heat up. Can't get any hotter than 12. And 12 is coming from 8. So 12 is going to be a sat liquid here. So 6 is basically where that 5 is. So let me put an arrow to it. That's 6. And so here is 12. All right. So from 12, let's keep going there. So 12, we're going to steam trap. So we're going to trap down to what pressure? To 13. And 13 is the same pressure as 14 and 10. All right, so we're going to actually trap down all the way down to this curve here. All right, so we're going to trap down to 13. So that's constant H, constant enthalpy. So you can't really see that constant necessarily on this diagram because it's a TS diagram. So, but it goes down because as the pressure drops, we're going to generate steam. So we're going to be some quality when we get to that lower pressure. All right, so did we get everything here? We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. 15, we also trapped down from 14 to 15. All right, so we'll put 15 on there. The lowest pressure as it goes back to the condenser. And I think that's about it. All right, so if you have any questions, let me know. Hope this was helpful as looking at how I would draw up a TS diagram. And again, this we worked from the ideal Rankine cycle, so we didn't really need many values. We just needed to know a couple things with state 11 or somewhere on any of these turbines. If was anything two phase, and only 11 was two phase, and everything else was these interdop. Assumption was sat liquids, and then 3. Couldn't be higher than 14, 6 couldn't be higher than 12, going through the closed feed water heater. And for the open feed water heater, which was at, coming off at 9, so 9, 4, and 3, they're all the same pressure. So there's 9, 4, 3, 4, and 9. All right, so again, any questions, please put them in the notes or in the comment section, and I'd be happy to get back to you. All right, thanks.